Welcome to Homeopathic Pharmacy Academy. In this video lecture, I am going to discuss about the standardization of homeopathic drugs. That means the standardization of raw material and finished product. So by the term standardization, it means that it is a process of having a product in uniform standard as mentioned in the pharmacopoeia. We know that pharmacopoeia is the final word. It is the authentic book. Which is dealing with the identification and preparation of homeopathic drugs. So every homeopathic pharmacopoeia, whether it is official or unofficial, having the directions of standardization. The process of standardization includes the quality control system with various tests to perform at different stages of manufacture from raw materials to finished product. That means from the drug substances, the raw materials, to in-process quality control and the finished product, that is the final medicine. It also involves an assurance and assessment of quality of product with reference to a pharmacopoeial monograph. So standardization does not contain a quality control system, not only contain the quality control system, but also it contains an assurance system. So by standardization, the customers, that is the physicians and the patients, are getting an assurance about the quality of the drug. Now let us see the steps involved in the process of standardization. The first step is the confirmation of drug identity. The correct identification of drug substance is very, very essential in the process of drug manufacture. Suppose if the drug is a wrong drug, if it is misidentified, then the finished product also will not be genuine. So the drug identity is very, very important, and that is the first step in the standardization process. Now next is the quality and purity of drug substance. That means to detect any impurities in the drug, it should be having very high quality as far as drug is concerned. So the second step is determination of drug quality and impurity. Now the third step is determination of the vehicles, its quality and purity. The purity of vehicle or solvent is as important as the purity of the drug, because it is the solvent or the vehicle which we used for extraction, for preservation, and for dispensing of medicines. So that the quality of vehicle is very, very important. Now the fourth step is detection of nature of adulteration. Even though we have identified the correct drug and we determine the quality and purity of the drug, we determine the quality and purity of vehicle, but if that drug is adulterated, there is no use. So detection of nature of adulteration is very, very important. Now the last one is estimating active constituents present in a crude drug. We all know the pharmacological activity of drug depends on various constituents, pharmacologically active constituents in the drug substance. If it is a vegetable drug or a plant drug, it may contain active constituents like alkaloids, glycosides, saponins, tannin, oils, etc. So these are the pharmacologically active constituents. We call it as phytoconstituents in case of plants. So estimating the appropriate quantity of active constituent is very, very essential to determine, to assess the pharmacological activity of that drug. So that is very, very important for estimation. Now, all these steps constitute the evaluation of drug. So what is evaluation? Evaluation is the confirmation of identity, determination of drug quality and purity, determination of vehicle quality and purity, then detection of nature of adulteration, and estimating the active constituents of the drug. Now, let us see the evaluation, what it contains. So what are the process involved in the evaluation? So there are three main process or two main objectives are there in the evaluation of drug. That is the determination of identity, purity and quality or activity of the drug. So we already seen. Now, let us see what is identity, what is purity, and what is the quality of the drug. Identity is its morphological characters, sensory characters, microscopic characters, chemical and microchemical test, and certain physical constants or physical parameters. So with these parameters, we are identifying the correct species, correct drug. Now, let us see what is purity. Purity is determined by estimating the foreign organic or inorganic matter and the moisture content. So purity means it is the pure form. So it should not be adulterated with any foreign substances, or it should not be contaminated by any foreign substances. So that is what is called purity. Now regarding quality, it should be determined by physical, chemical, biological methods. Now let us see the methods of drug standardization. So methods of drug standardization involves the five evaluation methods: organoleptic evaluation, microscopic evaluation, chemical evaluation, physical evaluation, and biological evaluation. So in this session, we are going to discuss about organoleptic evaluation and biological evaluation. Now, first we will see what is organoleptic evaluation. Organoleptic evaluation is the evaluation by means of organ of senses. So what are the organ of senses? Organ of senses are eyes, nose, ear, tongue, and skin, the sensory organs. So if a person evaluates the quality of a drug by using his sense organs, then it is known as organoleptic evaluation. It involves the study of morphology and other sensory characters of the drug. So sensory characters means by seeing a drug substance, a raw material, we can identify by smelling or tasting or by touching. So all these are sensory characters. So morphology is studied by means of sensory characters. Since majority of information on identity, purity, and quality of the drug material can be drawn from these observations from the sensory characters. And they are primary importance because the next or the further testing can be carried out based on this sensory parameters. So by a mere look, we can identify a well-known plant raw material. If you have a doubt in that species, you can go for the other higher forms of quality evaluations. However, the judgment based on sensory characters like odor, taste, etc. may be vary from person to person and time to time based on individual's nature. And these sensory characters or organoleptic evaluations is largely based on the person, the individual who is doing the quality control. And it depends on the knowledge and experience of the quality analyst. Now let us see what are the methods used in organoleptic evaluation. So the macroscopic appearance, that is a gross appearance of the drug substance, can be we can be visualized by the analyst. Suppose the some drug substance is having some strong odor, we can identify by smelling. Some may have a very characteristic taste. Some can be very soft or some are very hard and rough. So that can be identified by the mere touch. But some, especially some of the plant species, we can just break it and see the fracture. So the type of fracture determines the identification. So these are the different sources of methods to identify a drug in organoleptic evaluation. Now let us see the macroscopic appearance, how the quality or purity of the drug is assessed by seeing with the help of eyes. The macroscopic characteristics of a drug includes size, shape, color, fracture, and external mark. Now let us see each one. Size of crude drug may vary from because of their length, diameter, and width are different. The size of crude drug can be measured by either by a scale or by vernier calipers in terms of millimeter, a centimeter, meter, feet, etc. For example, Aconitum napellus is a very common homeopathic drug. It's a plant which grows up to height of 2 meters. So a tree which grows up to 3 meters can be aconite, along with the other characteristic features of the identification. Now, coming to an animal drug, a snake, Lachesis attains a length up to 7 feet and its poison fangs are nearly 1 inch long. So this is one identification feature of poisonous snake Lachesis, where we are taking the poison of this particular drug for preparing the medicine. Now the shape of substance helps in the identification, be it a plant or animal. For example, Allium sepa. Allium sepa, the bulb is pear shape. Allium sepa is nothing but the onion, tunicated, bearing fibrous root from its base. So with this we can identify the bulb of Allium sepa. Now Allium sativum, having a slight difference between Allium sepa. Allium sativum is nothing but it is a garlic. It is subglobular compound bulb, grayish white, 4 to 6 centimeters in diameter, consisting of 8 to 20 cloves in the bulb. Now there are some more roots, some more examples. For example, root. So by seeing the root, you can identify which species of drug it is. If it is conical, it may be aconite. If it is cylindrical, the sarsaparilla root, it is cylindrical. Jalapa root is fusiform. You can see the one end is tapered with the fibrous root in Jalapa. And we can see the aerial root in Ficus indica or Ficus bengalensis. That is a banyan tree. So with this, these are some characters which can be easily identify the particular species of plant. Now let us see the external marking. External marking is how the drug look externally. So that is one of the very important feature of identification. It may be classified as a furrows in the stem or in the root. That is alternate ridges and valleys due to shrinkage of internal parts caused by drying. Okay. So sometimes you can see in the stem or root, the bark, you can see some alternate ridges or valleys. Sometimes there may be presence of wrinkles. Fine or delicate furrows are known as wrinkles. So sometimes it is very hard and deep. Sometimes it will be delicate and fine. Annulations. Annulations are the transverse ring-like marking on the exterior surface of the plant. It may be a root or a stem. Sometimes fissures may be present. Fissures are deep split extending into the tissues. Nodule, sometimes rounded outgrowth on the surface of stem or root can be seen. It's known as nodule. Sometimes there may be some scars in the plant. They may be produced due to the injury or cut. So these are some identification parameters to identify the plant species. Now, these are some examples. See the annulations which are seen in Ipecac root. See, this is a transverse annulations. Now, Abroma augusta, the root is dull brown and longitudinally wrinkled with a small warty marking. So with these identification points, we can identify Abroma. Now, Alstonia scholaris. Alstonia scholaris, we can identify with the older bark with a very rough, uneven and much fissured. Now let us see the bark. Bark occurs in different shape. It can be flat bark, like in the case of Cularia saponaria. So now we can see
In this picture, you can see the flat bark,
curved in Punica granatum. In Punica granatum, the bark may be curved like this. Sometimes the bark can be channeled like acacia fistula. See, in this you can see the channeled bark. Sometimes, like in the case of Cinchona officinalis, the bark can be single quill. So this is the example for single quill. Then frangula, in the plant frangula, the bark may be a double quill. See here, you can see the example of a double quill. Sometimes there may be compound quill like this. And the bark having two surfaces, the outer and inner. Inner surface are usually lighter in color than outer. So this is about the bark of the plant. Now let us see the stem. Sinjipar, the part used is rhizome, whereas in colchicum autumnale, the part used is comb. And Aliensepa, the part used is bulb, whereas in Cephalandra indica, the part used is tendril. So these are the different forms of stem or modified forms of stem. Now let us see the flowers. Flowers, the color of the flower, inflorescence, that is arrangement of flower, arrangement of sepals, petals, ovary, style, stigma. So with all these parameters, all these things, we can identify a particular flower which is different from another species. Now if we go for inflorescence, there are different types of inflorescence like umbel, cyme, raceme, spike, etc. So here you can see different forms of inflorescence, that is arrangement of flowers. If it is ampel inflorescence, then it can be Ethusa cynapium and Allium sepa. In Alstonia scholaris, the inflorescence may be cyme, whereas in Alfalfa, the inflorescence in raceme. Whereas in Agnus cactus and Hyoscyamus niger, it will be like a spike, like this. So with the inflorescence, we can identify the correct species to some extent. Now let us see fruit. Fruit can be berry, nut, legume, or drupe. So berry you can see in a Proteagus or a Viscum album, whereas in Aesculus glabra and Areca catechu, the fruit in the form of nut. In Cassia acutifolia, the fruits are in the form of legume. In Agnus cactus and Cocculus indicus, fruits are in drupes, that is in grouped one, that is known as drupe. Now next is external color. So how external color can be useful in the determination of correct species. So this external color should be always checked in the sunlight. It should not be checked in the artificial light. The crude drug may acquire a variety of colors. The color of crude drug vary from white to yellowish gray, yellowish brown, reddish orange, or brownish black. So every species of plants having its own characteristic color. So we can identify the species to the some extent with the external color of that species. The fruits and seeds of crude drug having different colors. Bark possesses brownish gray to brownish black color, and the internal and external color of bark varies. internal color is little lighter than the outer one. So here in the picture we can see this is a picture of a bark where the inner bark is lighter in color whereas the outer part of the bark is rough and it is darker in color. Now let us see some of the examples. Sinjibar or ginger may be pale yellow, whereas sarsaparilla is deep yellow. Naxomica can be light pale brown, whereas cinnamon or clove may be dark brown. Cinchona officinalis we can identify with its dark reddish brown. Cinnamonum, the inner portion of the bark is red color. So these are some examples we can identify the color, identify the plant with its characteristic color. Now let us see the fracture of the plant. Suppose if the plant breaks when subjected to sufficient pressure, how it breaks? So that can give a clue to identification. And there are mainly three types of fractures: the complete fracture, incomplete fracture, and short fracture. In complete fracture, the trunk breaks completely when the pressure is applied. So that may be some unique to some species of the plant. But some type of fracture, it does not break completely when the fracture is applied. So that may be incomplete fracture. Short fracture is the drug or the plant break with a snap sound when the pressure is applied. So it will fracture very easily with some sound. Now we can see some of the types of fracture or nature of fracture. And with this nature of fracture, how we can identify, or with this nature of fracture, how we'll get some clue to identification. If the fracture is even, that will be smooth surface. If it is uneven, it is irregularly broken surface. The granular means the grain-like appearance in the fracture, whereas a hard fracture is a compact surface. Horny fracture is horn-like. It will project to outside, horn-like surface. Powdery fracture is the powdery surface. So that will be present, the powder may be present in the both end of fracture. Resinous fracture means it may have some smooth glossy surface at the site of fracture. Now let us see some examples of fractures. Examples of drug and which having a characteristic fracture. Apis canadensis may have a rough fracture, whereas Aconitum napellus may be horny or mealy fracture. Allosocotrina, it breaks with uneven porous fracture. Alstonia scholaris or Alstonia constricta, the fracture may be short, granular in the outer layer of fibrous inner and fibrous in the inner. In Alstonia scholaris, the fracture is short and smooth, transverse surface shows a narrow inner portion transverse by numerous fine medullary rays and a spongy outer portion of varying extent. So this is a characteristic fracture of Alstonia scholaris. Now let us see the other feature, that is order. How this order can be helpful in identification of the correct species. So it is a very sensitive criteria based on the individual perception, because the auditory perception or the olfactory perception may vary from individual to individual. So order may be divided into two main classes, a distinct order, that is camphorous or clove soil order, or indistinct order. So distinct order, it is a characteristic order, so we can easily identify, whereas indistinct order, it is very difficult to identify with a indistinct order. Depending on the amount of volatile constituents, the drug process, the different orders may be like aromatic order, that is the pleasant order, acceptable order, alicious order, that is like that of a garlic, order like that of a garlic, camphorous order, that is like that of a camphor. That these alicious and camphorous are very strong orders. Sometimes there may be spicy odor. In case of clove or cinnamon, we can have spicy odor. So again, there are some examples. Alstonia scholaris may be odorless, whereas acetic acid may have a strong odor of vinegar. Carbolic acid is having a very fetid odor and pleasant odor. Eagle marmalus may have a faintly aromatic odor. Agnus cactus may be strong aromatic odor. Aristolochia serpentaria may have a camphorous odor. Arnica montana may be having an apple-like odor. Asafoetida is very pungent odor or alicious odor. So these are the some example for a characteristic odor and the drug. Now let us see the next parameter, that is a taste. So usually the crude drug cannot be tasted because of some may be poisonous or some may cause allergic reactions. So sarsaparilla or honey may have a sweet taste, whereas lemon may have a sour or acidic taste. Natramure, as you know, it is salty or saline in taste, whereas jalapa is acrid taste or irritating taste. And they are having some distinct sensation to the tongue. If it is mucilaginous or oily, it can be linseed. Zingiber or ginger may have a pungent taste. Aconite or coca may have a acrid or irritant taste. Ipecac is having a nauseous taste. That means it may provocate the nausea. Now let us see the next parameter, that is touch. So boric acid may greasy to touch, whereas coprum aceticum is very smooth to touch. Paraffin is greasy. Nexomica seed is smooth, very smooth with some hairy feeling. Sugar of milk is gritty, and sulfur is also gritty. So this is how we can identify by mere the touch. Okay. So with this, we are concluding the organoleptic evaluation. Now let us see the next evaluation, that is a biological evaluation. The biological evaluation, the significance of biological evaluation is, it is a response produced by test drug and is compared with the standard preparation. So biological evaluation, basically the evaluation by means of testing a drug in the lower animals. So it can be in a live animal, or it can be in an isolated part or isolated organ of the animal. So the importance or significance of biological evaluation is the response produced by test drug as compared with the standard preparation. This method is generally used when standardization is not done satisfactorily by chemical or physical method, mainly to identify the activity of the drug than the quality of the drug. When the quantity of drug or sample is very less than drugs evaluated by biological methods. And these methods are performed in a living animal, isolating living organ or tissues, or animal preparations, or microorganisms. And it can be also known as bioassay. The bioassay is commonly used for biological assay or assessment or biological standardization. And that is a type of scientific experiment. A bioassay involves the use of live animal or plant or tissue or cell to determine the biological activity of the substance. And suppose if the bioassay is conducted in a live animal or plant, it is called as in vivo experiment. And if it is done on a tissue or cell, then it is known as in vitro experiments. But for both in vitro or in vivo, the objective is to determine the biological activity of the substance, drug substance. Now let us see what are the studies conducted or evaluations conducted by means of biological evaluation. Anti-inflammatory activity, analgesic activity, antipyretic activity, anti-ulcer activity, anti-diabetic activity, anti-helminthic activity, cardiac activity, neurological activity, and microbiological activity. There are some few examples for bioassay or biological evaluation. So these are cardiac glycosides containing drug like digitalis are bioassayed on cat, frog, or pigeons. Evaluation of ergot or cecale coordinator. Ergot is an alkaloid of ergot is nothing but it is a cecale coordinate. It is done on rabbit intestine or uterus. So the alkaloids can be ergotin or ergotometrin, etc. Saponin, another variety of glycoside, is assayed by hemolytic index on fish. So fish is used to analyze or assay the saponin. Curare causes relaxation of muscles and is carried out by rabbit head drop method. Curare, as you know, it is an arrow poison. It is a muscle poison which causes the relaxation of muscles. And the assay is carried out in rabbit by head drop method. So these are the examples of bioassays. Now we are concluding the evaluation by means of organoleptic evaluation as well as the biological evaluation. Thank you all.